Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I want to talk about perimeter. Perimeter is the distance around an object, and for all of our shapes, I will use the idea to find the perimeter you add all sides. Although you will find that some instructors will give you specific formulas for some shapes. Perimeter is measured in linear units or units to the first power. We typically use a capital P when we talk about perimeter, and for my formula, I'm just going to say add all sides. Finding the perimeter of an object is a useful skill that you will eventually need to call upon if you live on your own, because there's going to be some project you have to do at home that calls for it. Artists, carpenters, welders, maintenance people, electricians, landscapers, and do-it-yourselfers all know that if you want to line it, weld it, fence it, trim it, or frame it, you need to know how much material is needed to complete the job. You must be able to make a good estimate of the perimeter you are working with before you buy your supplies, or you could spend a lot of extra money or make a lot of extra trips to the hardware store. Being good at math makes you more efficient and may save you money. So let's look at these shapes below. The first one is a rectangle, and what I know about rectangles is that opposite sides are congruent or have the same length. So I know that this one is also 1.4 feet. And across from that is also 0.8 feet. And that's important because when I find the perimeter of something, I want to find all four sides, not just two that are given, right? Add all sides. So I have 1.4 plus 0.8 plus 1.4 plus 0.8. And I think that's going to be 4.4. But you can use your calculator to check that. I'm going to say the perimeter equals 4.4. feet, just adding those up. And it's linear units, so it's just feet, whatever unit you started off with. Now on this one, we have four measurements, but we only have three sides. And what I need you to see is that this is not a side. This is the height. So that has nothing to do with perimeter. So our perimeter is going to be 4 1/5 plus 4 1/5 plus 2 1/2. And you can change those all into tenths and then add those up if you'd like. I'm going to just use the calculator because I just wanted to show you that you could have any kind of measurement. It doesn't have to be whole numbers or decimals. It could be fractions that you're working with. If you know how to use your calculator, that's not a problem. I can enter this as a mixed number. Do you see how 4 times 5 is 20 plus 1 is 21 fifths? So I'm going to say 21 fifths. Plus another 21 fifths. Whoops, that's not what I wanted. Plus 21 fifths. Plus, and then I have 2 times 2 is 4, plus 1 is 5, 5 halves. And that gives me 109 over 10. I can change that to a mixed number if I want, or I can leave it as improper, depending on what my instructor would ask me to do. But 10 goes into 109 10 times with 9 left over. So that's another way you could just go ahead and put that back into this format. And then it's still going to be inches, though. All right. The third one, regular hexagon. Well, what do we know about regular? Regular means that all sides are the same. So if they give you one side, then you know all of them. And I could write 12 plus 12 plus 12 six times, but I know that I could just write it this way too, 6 times 12. That would be another way to do that. And 6 times 12 is 72, and then I have yards because, again, my units don't change when I'm finding perimeter. They stay the same. All right, what if I was given an irregular shape like this one? Well, in an irregular shape, you have to figure out all the missing sides. You can see that I don't know what this side is in this particular picture, and I don't know what this one is either. And so I need to figure out what they are. Well, let me draw this rectangle out this way and this way. When it's drawn this way, it should be clear that the top is as long as the bottom. And if I took this 2 meters and I slid it up here, you can start to see that the entire length of this should be 7. And down here, the entire length should be 7. And this is 1, which means this part must be 6. And I'm going to use the same unit. A little trickier over here, I have 3, but I have 2. So I can see that if I were to draw this one, this part would be 1 because this is 3 and this is 2, so that must be 1 right in here. And I'm going to slide that over and call that 1. And this whole thing is 3, which means the part up here must be 2, because 2 plus 1 would give me the 3. So I'm going to slide that over and call that 2 meters. Tricky. And each one is a little different, so you have to think it through. All right, so now I'm just going to add up all the sides. I want to make sure that I add all the sides, so I'm going to circle them as I go, because that's a common mistake, is to leave one off. So I'm going to say 3 plus 2 plus 2. This isn't one of my sides. That's something I wrote in, right? Plus 5 plus 3 plus 6 plus 2 plus 1. And I can just add all those up to get that 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 12, 15, 24 meters. And of course, if you feel like maybe you made a mistake in adding, or maybe I made a mistake in adding, I don't really want to go on without checking that. So I'll just check it really quick. 3 plus 2 plus 2 plus 5 plus 3 plus 6 plus 2 plus 1 is 24. Okay. And the second one over here, we only are missing one piece, and that's this piece right here. And again, we think about this whole entire bottom is 9, and so this whole entire top should be 9. And I have 4 and 3, which is 7, which means this has to be 2 down here. Oh, this is centimeters. And so now I'm going to add those up, and again, I'm going to do my little trick of circling as I go so I don't miss any. And it doesn't matter where you start, but you just want to go all the way around and add those up. And once you get those added up, then you put those onto your calculator. Notice I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 sides and 8 things that I'm adding. That's how I can feel confident that I didn't miss any. 5 plus 4 plus 2 plus 2 plus 3 plus 3 plus 6 plus 9. Is 34. What's the unit? Well, the unit is centimeters. And then the last one is a word problem. Marta wants to make a frame for her grandmother's quilt that is 7.5 feet or 7.5 feet by 10 feet. How many feet of board must she purchase to complete the project? Well, she's got a frame and it's got two dimensions given, so I think we should have probably said rectangular frame, but maybe we can imply that. So she's got 10 feet on one side and 7.5 feet on the other. Notice that I only have two dimensions like we had up in our first problem in the video, but that still means if I want to build this, I can't just build two sides. I need all four sides to build a frame. And once I do that, I can add all those up and have 7.5 plus 10 plus 7.5 plus 10, 15, 25, 35. Feet that she would need to make that project. All right, have a great day.